Hey everybody, it's Mike Dooley, and we're continuing our celebration of my brand new Notes from the Universe on Love and Connection. It is a card deck made up of the best notes from the universe ever, the funniest, most insightful, that offer guidance in terms of relationships, love, getting your groove on, appreciating yours truly, in the sense of it being you. And so every day for the last couple weeks, I'm giving away a free card deck mailed to any address in the world. The way you can win today is type a question below about love and connection. I will answer it. If I answer your question, we will arrange for you to get the card deck. And to kick this off, I'm going to do a reading, a random reading. This is what people do with card decks, angel card decks, notes from the universe card decks. You think of a question, maybe first thing in the morning, or just go fresh without a question and see what you get randomly out of the deck and find its meaning in your life. And these cards have a note on one side and then extra guidance on the other. So here is today's card. It came from a note that went crazy viral, super popular. When a thing hurts your eyes, stop looking at it. When it hurts your ears, stop listening to it. And when it hurts your heart, stop justifying it. I love you so much, the universe. Create space for new love. So there you go. Stop justifying that thing which is bringing you pain. You needn't suffer. You needn't beat yourself up. You needn't find fault in yourself. You are more than the circumstances you've been through. You are more than someone's attitude or treatment of you. You are more than the times you slipped and fell and made a mistake. You are an eternal being of love and joy. You are an otter of the universe. Otters, the playful, fun-loving creatures that like to swim and slide on mudslides. Okay, we are, according to Richard Bach in his awesome book, Illusions, the otters of the universe, here to play, to love and be loved. And we need to get out of our own way to do that. So if you've got an issue going on with somebody right now, and it's hurting your heart, whether it's something they did or said, or whether it's something you did or said, move forward, go ahead, forgive, let go, dream on, and take actions on those dreams. Thy will be done. All right, now let me answer a question. Has anybody asked a question yet? How do I connect more with people who have different view to my own? Thank you, go girl. Okay, go girl, send an email to ivy@tut.com, ivy@tut.com, and she is going to hook you up with an entire card deck, 60 beautifully designed notes from the universe on love and connection. How do I connect more with people who have different view to my own? By focusing upon and celebrating all that you do have in common. I remember having an epiphany when I walked through my college campus, University of Florida, a few decades ago, 3.5, and there was nobody anywhere. And then suddenly, I'm crossing a street and somebody came around a corner. They stood waiting for a bus. I walked within 10 feet of them. And I just remember thinking, I know nothing about this person. Nothing about this person. But that we have so much in common. Not just because we're at the same university. Not just because we're sharing a physical proximity in time and space. But we are the eyes and the ears of God Almighty come alive in the dream of life. We are learning about our power. We're beginning to recognize life's beauty. We're beginning to see the potential for us to live the life of our dreams, every single human being. We all put on our pants one leg at a time. We all have some issues with a parent or a partner or a kid, a best friend that's disappointed us. We all are struggling to find our passion and our purpose. I mean, it's like we're all the same person, but with just slightly different facets and features based on different pressures life has given us. But yet still we eat three meals a day. Yet still we wonder if anybody cares about who we are. So, to answer your question, focus on what you've got in common. Focus on what's good. In this world today, for example, there's so much divisiveness when we look at our opinions on abortion, gun control, these other things that will tear two people apart fighting. So don't go there. Simply don't go there. Every one of us is looking for our little place, our little shade in the sun. And that is more than enough to go on to build relationships and then ultimately perhaps talk about differences. Okay, so I'll also realize that sometimes, I've certainly seen it in my life, that differences attract. You know, I know like attracts like. That's the vibe. But complementary worldviews can be really compelling and interesting and add a lot to a relationship. So don't think that it's all bad that you aren't exactly the same. Okay, thank you, Go-Go Girl, for the great question. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. Tomorrow, I'm going to give away another card deck to some other questioner. And until that time, remember, thoughts become things. Choose the good ones, and you are adored.